today we're back in Birmingham doing something a little bit ridiculous. I've got this Sony 200 to 600mm lens and we're going to do some city photography. Architecture, street photography style stuff with a lens that's definitely made for wildlife and birds, birding. I don't do any of that. I bought this for landscapes, took it up into the mountains on just two occasions and haven't found it very useful. It sat around as a bit of a dust collector for a year or so. It was a nice idea. Everyone told me it was a stupid idea for landscapes, but I stand by that it was a decent idea. However, it was pretty useless. It's too big and long to fit in your bag. It's too heavy to carry around. When shooting video, it's too wobbly in the wind. It catches the wind quite a lot, and it's definitely more suited to photography. I don't do much though. I don't do any street photography really. I don't do much architecture. But I have a few friends that do street photography. They're always knocking out really good stuff. I can never find the shots. But they use wide lenses a lot. 14mm, 20mm, 35mm, 50mm maybe. And I thought, what the heck, let's take this into the city centre and let's see what we can get. Something interesting, hopefully, or maybe just a complete waste of time, but I thought it was worth a go. Hello mate, you alright? Yeah. Yeah. Well, not so much photography, more video, but I thought I'd try something.
Like, I mean, if I wanted to, what is it? I want to take like close ups of like, I've got watches, I've got some nice watches. So what?
Yeah, you don't want anything like this. No, you want a macro lens.
Oh, well, macro lens, yeah.
This is a long lens that. Most people would use this for birds and stuff and wildlife.
Oh, I got you, mate. Yeah, but I probably would want something like that.
Well, if you want a close, be able to focus closer, and they call it macro.
Yeah.
This doesn't focus until I struggle to focus on that building.
Get to the top of that.
It's not ideal for cities, but I thought. Give it a go.
What do you do then? Do you sell your stuff on to like
photography? Like, not so much. No, I do video for a living.
Oh, do you? But, so it's all video then? Yeah. Okay.
But photography is just more of a hobby than anything.
And it's a nice.
It's a bizarre lens to use in a city, so I thought sometimes you get the best stuff by doing something that's not ideal, really. But
use that as well. Video.
Yeah, I put together a little video to put them on YouTube.
Oh, you do? Yeah. You're a YouTuber, right?
Yeah, well, I wouldn't say I'm a YouTuber, no. But I'll put some videos together and stick them on there.
Mate, there's so much content that goes on there, you might as well be part of it. It's great, it is. I tell you, it's all I ever watch anyway, mate.
Yeah, it's good, isn't it? Yeah. Have a good one, mate. My arm is aching already. Been here 10 minutes. Thank you, mate. Cheers. Hard work pushing it, isn't it? Quite nice guy with a briefcase. You're okay, mate. Thank you. It's so difficult. Good fun, though. Problem with street photography. With wide lenses, although the shots are obviously fantastic and I'm no good at it, which is why I'm out with this big beast. It is quite overt, you're in people's faces. This, at least you can be discreet, hide 100 metres away behind some bushes in the shade and get some pretty cool stuff. And this guy down here eating his sandwiches. Difficult to keep this bloody thing stable. buildings like Tetris